Greetings, everybody, in the name of the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Italist one coming at you again. Live and direct. If you don't know me, get to know me. Subscribe to my YouTube channel. I am Italist. On our platform, X, Instagram, Facebook, I am Italist. Welcome. Another happy Wednesday. Welcome, everybody. You are welcome. Welcome to our subscriber and our follower. Welcome. I had to reach out today, man. Today, I had to reach out because, you know, the middle of the week is two more days to Friday, and sometimes you feel good because you made it this far. And then sometimes you feel exhausted, right? Because every day is a good day. For once we get up, every day is a good day. But you feel exhausted sometimes, man. Because, you know, say there's only two more days to go. But it seems like somehow the enemy want to keep messing around. And, you know, I wouldn't say the enemy should stop, because if he stop, he not nothing to do. You know what I mean? And his agenda is to mess with God pick me. That's his agenda, you know. Mess with God pick me them any which way possible. And if you're lackadaisical, he not have to really mess with you. But when you're upon the alert and you're conscious that we are living in a spiritual world, dealing with spiritual entity, and God is spirit, right? Thus, know say every day you're gonna have to lean on Him. You're gonna have to depend on Him to take you through every situation, every battle, every turn, every relaxation moment. You have to depend upon Him, right? I when you think say a peace and safety, a sudden destruction. You see me? So you still have to depend upon Him. Yes, I tell this one man. I tell with you. Yeah. And today, made it feel like it are one of those days, you know. Go up on a mission and all is well. May not reach back of my yard yet, but all is well, same way. But then, it does have a spiritual, you know, revelation. Let me just come by my mother. Come put some flowers upon her grave, you know, and just take her meds, you know. You don't know what it is, but it still never feel kosher. But then now me just say, all right, let me go to a podcast, you know, and let me just come in and talk with the people. Then it's pre-recorded, by the way, but either way I'm still glad me I talk to, you know. And you know, me can't forget to, you know, because you support me, you know what I mean. You leave a little comments, you likes, you subscribe, you know, so I can't forget you, you know. And it's not about money and fame, you know. If that come, to God be the glory. If it don't come, God be the glory. What is important is the connection, the link, right? With our people and with other people who have the heart of God, the mind of God, and know say, better days must come. Better days must come, man. You know, let me talk about humble beginnings. Yeah, humble beginnings, despite not humble beginnings, because humble beginnings make it the man or the woman. And let us not forget, right? Because some people, you know, when they reach a certain place in life, them forget about them humble beginnings. Yeah. When they get money, when they get husband, then get wife, then get children, some of them forget their humble beginnings. Whether intentionally or not intentionally, some really and truly, some forget. Some forget when them had only one subscriber, one follower. Some forget when them have only one item to them name or one parent. Yeah. Some forget these humble beginnings. Right? The one roof. The one bedroom. And now they gone into 5 bedroom and 8 bedroom and 10 bedroom house. When them live in apartment and then gone to mansion. You know, humble beginnings. Right? Many of you who have gone abroad or become successful, when you land in this country, we then call America, you come with one suitcase. I remember my mother used to always tell me, say, when they come to America, and come with one suitcase. And now them can travel with 5 and 6 suitcases. Go back anywhere they can go. Yeah, humble beginnings, man, despite not humble beginnings. Sometimes when me used to hear them talk, you know, used to wonder what they really talk about, you know, what they really talk about. But then, you know, me grow a little older, and me understand what it is now when they say, despite not humble beginnings. Yeah, humble beginnings, man. There's some kind of, it's a heavy load to carry, even though it might sound, you know, very, what's the word? Very mediocre, yeah? But to be in a humble position, right, where mean you don't really have no control over it, you know. At that, me did I look upon with my mother, you know. When the situation of life and death, when I have no control over it, you know. We really don't have any control over it. Especially if you grow old, you know, so you're gonna die eventually. And if you're pregnant, you know, so you're gonna give birth. But it's not a must. Right? You don't have control over it. So you must always be thankful and you must remain humble. Try to endure, right? Hardship, right? Because whether it's life or it's death, it is a hardship. The woman them push out baby, it's hard, it's nothing easy about it. And when you die sometime, you're not ready for go. Most of the time, you're not ready for go. Few of us can say, you know, that they know somebody that live a full, full life and they was ready to depart. You know what I'm saying? And them depart in a nice way, right? With like them full health. Them depart during them sleep or something, you know what I'm saying? Healthy and strong. You know? That wasn't the case with my mother, but at the same time, she was humble. We know that for a fact. Always easy. You know? She knew about, you know, the isms and schisms that this world bring. She never take it upon herself. Maybe because she was a woman, you know what I'm saying? That men, we deal with things a little differently. But when she talk about her upbringing, and the humble take a shack them grow up in a, cause them never really grow up in a no house. They grow up in a little shack, a one bedroom, you know. And eight brother and sister, them day they don't know nothing about contraceptive. The woman them with nowadays, I take contraceptive, and they don't know nothing about pull out. You understand them a ride for glory. Yes. So all my uncle them and my auntie them, you know, and then come in love, right? Thank God for the parents and the ancestors, you know. But the humble beginnings, I remember missing my grandfather, and the man never have no whole heap of money. You know, my grandmother never have no whole heap of money, but them situation change when them children come abroad. And I used to, it was many years before I meet my grandparents. Many years. A matter of fact, I meet my grandparents when I get big. You know, big enough to comprehend that this is my grandparent. I never, like, come out the belly and see them. And I used to wonder how come sometime, you know, things kind of, me never understand it was dealing with money. I just start to come out of the sky, you know, but everything take money. And the parents, them, if them ever argue about money, me never hear them argue about money. Me never know. Sometimes me have a little pants on me and the pants too short. Me grow out of the pants and me still wear the pants. And me complain. I never know say we are take care of our ancestor them. I never know say them a contribute to building a little house for them to live in so that them can comfortable. You understand? Humble beginnings me talk about, you know. And when we did finally meet my grandparents, it made sense now. Like, me meet all the family member them. Everybody come from near and far. The extension of the family line now coming from America. And the big project are going on. Everybody feel very happy to know that we never forgot them, right? Because, mind you, there is an opportunity. The opportunity was that you go to America and you can turn your back on those behind. But my mother never stayed, so she would rather live in a small apartment and do a mediocre job, including my father. But still help those who were left behind. Eh? Humble beginnings, man. It's a serious start. Serious start. And even me now, I look forward. You know, I still have, me come do the same. Me take care of family members, help out when we can, contribute when we can. Because our humble beginnings. And you see, this is the trick of the enemy, you know. The enemy want to distract us and things say, we reach. We reach to the top of the mountain. Right? But we never remember the climb. And a lot of time, that is the downfall of our people, you know. The things say, we go through all of these things and yeah, poverty is a crime. It's a crime to be poor, you know, I tell you that. But there is some blessings in being poor. There is some blessings. You know what I'm saying? You know, The rich man have a whole lot of problem, you know. The rich man have a whole lot of problem. But you see, sometimes with the poor man, even though he don't want to be poor, because nobody wakes up and say they want to be poor. But he can make it work. And if he gets something, he remember what it was like being poor. And he make up in his mind, say, yo, if me can stay away from it, let me stay away from it. You know, I go back. But it's hard. Especially when you see a man who reached some level of success and then go back to being poor. It make you wonder if that man or that woman ever consider humble beginnings. God put us through some things, you know, to remind us. And most of the time, it is just for us to take a step and say, yo, we are thinking about the little life that we have, the few years we have on earth. Right? And boom, bam, you see, you get a little blessing, but then you forget all of the one days that pass when you did have a little humbleness in your life. Instead of you curse it, you should have been blessing it and saying thank you, God, because you know it's a better days are going to come. Don't it? Better days are going to come. Yeah. So, you know, me they come here, put the flowers and thing, but they know what me I going to think about, you know, what me they going to talk about. You know, me tell her some personal things. Me go move on. But now me reflect, you know, after that. Me don't even move from the spot yet. Me still move though. Me go move now. And me said to myself, you know, what I could have talked about? What me could have talked about? You know? Because there's always a message, always some kind of message when you come at him place, yeah, that they might try to tell us, but we don't get it. You know what I mean? We don't get it. But I think we get it. God bless her. God bless these people. You know, because yeah, my humble beginnings is a serious thing. I mean, I even have family members right now. I tell you, them think they rich, you know. But me not say nothing. Me encourage them same way. Me love them same way. You know, and God have to deal with them, because who's me to go tell them about humble beginnings? You know what I mean? All them know say it was hardship, you know, that them endure, and that is it, you know. So we can't tell them anything, you know. And we can't talk to myself and talk about others, my experience. Right? And, you know, me talk with a lot of other people too. It's not just me. I was speaking with a brother not too long ago, you know, and he's telling me how he's taking care of his family members. I seen a couple of videos on YouTube the other day. A lot of people taking care of other people, and then don't forget humble beginnings, you know? Then don't forget humble beginnings. One guy living out of a van, you know? One guy living out of a van. And, you know, basically, You know, it might have been shower, it might have been fridge, it might have in bed, a cargo van, you know. Anybody know a cargo van, one of them Ford F-150, I mean 250, I believe, cargo van. They retrofit it and turn it into you know, like a living space. Can you imagine? Yeah, a lot of people here living. They reach here and then think it's gonna be a bed of roses. They make a little money, but you only make enough to survive. So they call it cost of living, right? But then, because them have responsibilities, right, from relatives and of that nature, you know what I mean? It's very difficult for them to enjoy some of the money that them have, you know? It's very difficult. So them can't really do anything. You know what I'm saying? All them can do is just basically live. You know what I mean? That's all them can. That's all them can do is just live. And with that, the money can basically pay for a little space over them head. Yeah. A lot of people like that in America, they only can pay for a little space over them head. So they left out of the frying pan and jump into the fire. And they have a little phone, maybe that is a plus. They have a little TV, that is another plus. You know what I mean? Because the work is here. And people can you know, find work. If you really want work, people can find work. So the work is here. You understand? No matter what you want, anything you want to do, if you are clean toilet or you are cooking a kitchen, work in a hospital, you know, them lawyer, them big profession, you know, so you have to go to school. But this, the work is still here. You understand? It's just up to you what you want to do and if you're willing to do it, if you not have pride. You understand? So, the humble beginnings is always a reminder. Different from the people that were born here now, right? Where at times too, if they're not careful, right? They will make the mistake or the wrong decision and not really look into whichever the humble beginnings may be. You know what I'm saying? And this is why, you know, it come to my mind, you know, because the enemy, I watch, you know, and a talky-talky, and a platy-platy. Every chance in get, real talk, the enemy a watchy-watchy, a platy-platy. Every chance in get, because it's survival of the fittest when you come abroad, you know. Maybe so much in your own country. In your own country, you know it's survival of the fittest, but you're amongst your own people. But we who are here now, we divided. We're not so much united, as they say, United States. We're not so much united, we're more divided. Because you have different nationality and everybody wants to stay on top. Right? But for the most part, a lot of them come from humble beginnings. You know? A lot of them come from humble beginnings, you know, and the way the place designed, you can live a decent life. If you put your mind to it, you know what I mean? You can live a little decent life. Now, he not going to give in to you because, you know, see them have them rules and regulations and them, you like me say, platy-platy and talky-talky and watchy-watchy, right? He not going to give in to you. But if you're alert, right? If you listen to this podcast, right? You can put two and two together, right? You can put two and two together and you can say, all right, America run this way, Canada run this way, England run this way, right? You see, you all were going over there because you're talking at the news, you know? You know about the migration. Everybody want to reach a foreign, you know? It's all over the news. So, when I'm driving now, so bear with me, all right, people? So, now, you kind of know, you know what I mean? There is possibilities, endless opportunities, right? Most of the time, it's not what you know, it's who you know. For some people, it's who you know, it's not what you know. Because people been here, you know what I mean, for generations. You know what I'm saying? So them have the upper edge, you know what I mean? And that is important, you know? When you're talking about survival of the fittest, that is important, that everybody do what they're supposed to do. Yeah? If you look out for your people, then you don't have no time for waste. You don't have no time for make bad decision and bad choice. You don't have no time for with people who don't understand the agenda and the mission. Right? Now me talk about money and me talk about prosperity and things like that. Wealth. Right? We're talking about that because you are in a place now where it can be done. Yeah? You can spread your wings. You have X amount of states. The country is a little bigger. You're not just, you know what I'm saying? You have access to wealth. Yeah? And believe you me, my mother, she did take advantage of it. Right? So in America now, which is, I don't know about other countries, I can only speak for America. If you don't have a dollar to your name, you can still work and save a little change, and you can apply for a thing called grants. Yeah? And funding is funding. So grants are funding, right? And you can go to school and get education. And once you're done that, you might have to pay it back. But depending on your profession, what you major in, and XYZ, you could pay that off in 1 year, and you can pay that off in 15 years. You understand? It's up to you how you want to live, you know? And if you don't pay it back, it just don't pay back, because either you're dead, or you know, you're just paying it till you die. Them not come after you as long as you have paid back. You understand? Some form of payment. That's why you see the people them right now, them are talking about something what them said, universal relief of debt for education. A lot of people still paying for their education. You know what I mean? And a lot of people would like to have that debt release. You know what I mean? Because they don't contribute.